Good evening, race fans. Welcome to the Core Racing Network. Tonight, the Core Vintage Series heads to Newton, Iowa, the Iowa Speedway, for 100 laps around this track. And I guess the best way to describe this track is probably Richmond on steroids. It's a little bit bigger than Richmond, Richmond being a three-quarter mile, and this one being just over a four-fifth mile, measuring at 0.857 miles. So just a little bit bigger than Richmond, but it's got the trioval feel, a little bit more banking than Richmond. So these guys are able to hold some speeds, hold the lines a little bit better, but it's not that easy. It's got a little progressive banking, but it seems like that the favored line is kind of right through the middle. With this track being under a mile, I'm sure my co-host Jimmy is breathing into a bag right now. So let him put the bag down and welcome Jimmy here in the booth. Jimmy, how's it going tonight, buddy?
I don't know where the bag's at, so I'm still hyperventilating. this isn't too bad. It's one of those tracks that's kind of like, I know it's under a mile, but there's like a few tracks that you don't mind hopping on. It's just when they really get down to that half a mile mark where I really cringe and like, why am I even going out here? But, and it's not, I don't think it's just because of the other people and that this is a hobby and, you know, not everybody's a professional driver. So it's just kind of, can the people around you keep it steady? But I think we're going to be in for a treat tonight here. Here at Iowa, you know, you got Dylan McDonald fastest at practice so far, as these guys head out on the track for some qualification, but not too far behind him is James Stokes and Sam Oliver. Sam's put on a show here at the beginning of the season so far in the last couple of weeks, so we'll see how things kind of head out. And I'll give a shout out there to Tony Bramble, as he's saying go toast. So we'll see if the toast machine can make it to the way up front, as he was seventh fastest overall during practice. So anyways, let's see these boys get some qualifying done and see where they lay.
Yeah, we'll get the link here in the Discord here in a second for anybody that's looking for it to share. But It should be good one here tonight. 100 laps is not going to be easy at this track. It's going to want to rip through the tires pretty well, and you know, we'll see how these guys handle it. And getting that in the pit road is certainly no easy feat. And that kind of resembles Richmond a little bit too. And it's hopefully the guys don't get confused, because the Legends Oval, there's almost kind of like a little drag strip going all the way down the front stretch. I'm not sure if they use this as a straight oval at some point or not, but it's got three lanes down in between the grass and the pit road wall. So hopefully the guys don't go down that road thinking that's pit road, because they ain't getting their stall from there. But looking at the first couple races, the first race of the season, we had Homestead and Sam Oliver doing a phenomenal job there and picking up the win. And then we go to Nashville Super Speedway for the second race, and Mark Gonzalez jumping into the series. Him and Dylan had some pretty good scraps and led about half the laps each, but it was Mark Gonzalez getting on top of the boards there. He's trying to get into the session tonight, but looks like maybe just sneaking in right now as qualifying is starting. So we'll see if Mark can try and go back-to-back here at Iowa, as this is, you know, kind of their first, I guess, true test of a short track. I mean, obviously Homestead, not a short track. Nashville Super Speedway, not under a mile. So I guess, you know, a taste of a little short track here at Iowa.
Yeah, it's kind of like that midway point, Carl. It's kind of like an introductory short track course, if you want to give it that. And like you said, it has some nice, decent banking on it. It's not too flat. Right now, it looks like James Suggs on the pole, the 25.512.
Yeah, still waiting to see if Dylan McDonald gets a time better than him. He was able to do that in practice, but James Suggs will be our in-race reporter, so we'll bring him in here momentarily. But yeah, I've had some experience, and I did some testing for this track for these guys. And to me, I mean, you can run the bottom, and it's a little bit quicker in the, you know, getting into and maybe through the middle of the corner. But you carry so much more speed when you're running that middle line. And kind of the top line is the wild card. The top line, I feel like some guys may be up there and be trying to save some tires. You're going to get some good runs off the corner from the high side, but to me, it just feels like, you know, the Goldilocks line, if you will, is in the middle. But see, everything shakes out right now. Looks like Mark Gonzalez is putting it P2 right now. And James Suggs is done, so we will go ahead and bring him into the booth here. And we have the number 20 here, James Suggs, now in-ring supporter here tonight. So, James, you've had kind of a, I guess, an up-down season so far. You finished P5 at Homestead, and then you come back and didn't really have as good a race at Nashville Super Speedway. Looks like you're favoring Iowa here a little bit, though.
Yeah, we're looking pretty good so far. This isn't one of my better tracks. This track's extremely difficult, and it's hard to figure out the groove here. And you know, you start on the bottom, and you have to finish near the top. It's this place is as big a challenge as probably any of them.
I know you guys had the practice, and not sure how much you got to run around some other cars. But how do you think the passing is going to be tonight? Do you think it's going to be a track where you can pass, or you think track position is going to be playing a huge part?
Well, track position is always huge. I think once if we can get, you know, 5 or 6 laps in and get settled and the car gets settled, we can race around then. You know, tires are going to start falling off, so you're going to have your comers and goers. So.
Yeah, should be pretty good when you're 100 laps on tap. And what's kind of going to be the mindset? Is it really just going to be looking after tires? Is it trying to get into your groove as early as possible, a little bit of everything?
I've always kind of considered myself kind of a Terry Labonte, Mark Martin guy. I save tires. I'm patient. I try not to get in a hurry because I don't want to use up stuff. That just seems like the best way to be. But it's all going to come down to tires. If it stays green, of course, if it doesn't go green, cautions start flying. And we're going to get new tires on them. We're going to be, you know, scrapping again on new rubber.
Well, certainly a good place to be saving tires is from the front, if you can certainly hold that pole position. A couple guys left to qualify. But before we let you get back down into the car and with the crew there, anybody you want to send a shout-out to or thanks to?
I want to shout-out to Woo Woo Garage and Lewis Nissan. Both of them are big supporters of us. And you guys, you know, Core. I haven't been here long, but I'm really liking the place. Y'all put on a good league.
We appreciate that, and hopefully kind of been looking to have that ebbs and flows come back up towards the top and have a good finish here tonight. If we get a chance, we'll try and pull you in if there's any kind of cautions. If not, maybe we'll talk to you as one of the top three at the end of the race.
Hey, looking forward. Fingers crossed.
All right, buddy. Good luck out there.
Thank you.
That the driver of the 20, James Suggs. And Jimmy, we're about a little over halfway through qualifying here, and it looks like most of the guys have put down lap times. Just taking a look at the boards, and it looks like really just Dylan McDonald yet to put down a lap time. He would be the 14th starter here tonight, and he was the fastest in practice, but you know, there's a reason that there's no lap time there. Either he's waiting for that track to cool down to get to a Goldilocks temperature, or maybe he had some issues going out there and tagging the wall and not being able to put down a line. But you see the rest of the guys out here and a little bit more spread out than we typically see. As you see, it's almost a full second from first all the way back to 13th. So these guys may end up getting stretched out once everything gets going here.
Yeah, I mean, Dylan, actually, he's points leader, so he will be starting from the back of the pack. So no qualification for that guy, as he will have to work his way to the front and earn his keep, as he already posted that he's already got some emotional damage and can't forget his championship implications, as coming from the back to the front will be a good chore tonight with James Sugg up there and Justin Sullivan and Mark Gonzalez putting down some pretty decent times.
It's a good thing I'm not the guy that makes up the rules for the league and, you know, forgetting the one of the main rules. You know, I would look really stupid if that was the case.
I wasn't calling you out, brother. Yeah. You said it.
Moving on.
What was that about? I'm reading and knowing the rules? Yeah,
apparently I was huffing out of the wrong paper bag myself, so. But nonetheless, so we do have everybody out there and done qualifying. Looks like Kevin Foster out here yet, just practicing some pit entries here. And this is not a bad thing to do here, especially, you know, once you're done qualifying, a lot of guys just, you know, run their qualifying laps and then park it. But it's a chance, especially when you have 10 minutes worth of qualifying, to do things like this. You know, it's, if you didn't get a chance to do it in practice, or even if you did, get some last minute tweaks and try and figure out, you know, where your entry is for pit lane, how you can you know, get on the gas coming out of pit lane and everything like that. So it's a really good time to practice that. So Looks like a new paint scheme on the number 8 there is the Quaker State, and it's definitely a little throwback paint scheme. I like the old Quaker State paint scheme. And
I don't know if Pure Trade paints is up to date. Mine's not. As I'm still showing you the number 8 of Miller. So yeah, we have some issues with the... hopefully it's your trading paints, not mine, as I'm the guy putting it over the air. So
yeah, I would think it's yours. It's mine's been having some issues all day. I tried to refresh it a couple times, and Dylan's isn't showing up correctly. And okay, so well for me it looks pretty cool with the old Quaker State out there. For everybody else in the entire world, apparently it is still the Miller scheme, and that's what I'm seeing in the broadcast as well. So we'll go with that one. Either way, good looking paint scheme for Kevin Foster, but. We are just about finishing up with qualifying as the 10 minutes will tick by, and we got our 14 car field is set and ready to go. So Jimmy, give us a rundown.
Yeah, so our rundown for tonight here, we will clear this out of the way so we don't have too much stuff on the screen. We'll show the qualifying results as James Suggs with Woo Woo Racing takes the pole tonight. Then Joseph Sullivan on the outside. In the second row will be Mark Gonzalez with James Ledford. Then followed by Tim Thompson and Tyler Bramble in row number 3. Sam Oliver and David Tilford rounding out row number 4. Brandon Polt and Kevin Foster in that row number 5. James Carman and Jeff Taylor in row number 6. And Craig Pierce along with Dylan McDonald, the points leader, in the back. To start this race for a 14 car field, 100 laps at Iowa.
Don't like that one. Keep giving me those goddams. I'm gonna go ahead and give him some more championship implications if he's not. If it's gonna be like that, but. Yeah, it's listen, apparently it's not a good day for broadcasting. I was watching Flow Racing earlier, watching some of the other super late model action down there at East Bay, and I mean, they keep bringing up, hey, it's the first, first broadcast of the season, or it's early in the season for these guys, but man, they're just anything and everything is going wrong. I mean, they had sound errors, they had putting up the wrong time and towers, then they had the Chili Bowl lineup instead of the Heat 1 lineup, so it was all kinds of over the place. So yeah, I guess I'm just joining right in with the festivities there. But our in-race reporter right there on the pole, James Suggs. So we'll see what the number 20 can do here, see how this thing is going to shake out. I'm interested to see how hard these guys are going to push early, and if they're going to spread out or not, or if it's going to be mixing up here a little bit. It's like Richmond, but I guess you may have some of the diving down into turn one to try and make a pass, but I don't know. I'm up in the air how this thing is going to turn out.
Yeah, I mean, James Suggs got a good-looking machine there, but I think his painter got his number a little upside down there on the roof. It looks like the O2 up top, so he might want to talk to his painter out there and get that corrected maybe for next week. But yeah, he is the 2-0, not the O2, as this like on the side of his machine. And then I'm just gonna leap to the field here of everybody's car, so everybody can kind of get a look at. Everybody's driving. There's 76 of Justin Sullivan, 48 of James Ledford, the Toast Machine, 39 of Tyler Bramble, David Tilford in the Thrustmaster number 12, Sam Oliver in the Teed Boats in the 59, Brandon Polt in the Ridgeline Builders number 71, there's Kevin Foster in at number 8, Miller. Just plain old black number 24 for Jeff Taylor, Craig Pierce in his staple 046 Kool-Aid machine. Jeff Taylor, he's still that black number 24. And Dylan McDonald in Rays number 38. And Mark Gonzalez sporting that old Mountain Dew Shine number 88.
They look like Mark Gonzalez maybe having some issues getting off of pit lane, but he will rejoin the field where he needs to right now. Looks like Tim Thompson trying to let him go by and get into that third position where he's going to be starting. So we are now all set, 14 cars in line, getting ready to take this green flag pace car. Lights are out. Who you got? Who you rooting for? You're going to see the 38 coming from the back and trying to keep that points leader. We're going to see one of the new guys here grab a win. It is go time here at Iowa. Pace car is in. We wait for Barney, and he is waving the green flag here at Iowa Speedway. Ooh, little bit of a rough start there. as that may end up being an early caution here. And that just looked like a bit of a rough start again by the 88. We've seen it, I believe it was last week, where he kind of missed the start and, or maybe not missed the start, but missed a shift on the start, and that just sent him right around. So, bit of a rough start there. At least Tim Thompson didn't get into any kind of wall, and I guess that little highway in the infield that I was talking about earlier helped him out for sure.
Yeah, enough to keep the car from, you know, not going down into a pit lane and, you know, getting a penalty down there. Is that's not one way to, you know, catch a your first lap before turn one, getting spun around, taken out. And it was just him kind of, you know, taking his time, checking up for Mark Gonzalez, and, you know, obviously getting kind of ran over by this, I think, who was it? James. So many people. Sam Oliver, excuse me. I think it was the 59. That happened. I can click back on that again here just to double check it. But I think it's the 58, like missed a shift. 59 gets him in the 05. Everybody kind of fans out. So just a little love tap, but enough to send him around, catch him on that highway, keep him out of pit lane. He's able to get back out on track. So, but first lap, caution one. And, you know, I don't know who's at fault, or if it's a miss shift, or if they're going to call that in the 88 or give him an EOL, or if it's the Sam Oliver taking the EOL for causing the caution on the first lap.
Yeah, it looks like discussing with the admins here, it's not going to be any penalty needed there, and certainly looks like Gonzalez just missed a shift there, and it just kind of bunched up the infield or the inside line there, and yeah, not a good start, but looks like Tim Thompson is going to be in pit lane there. He's going to get everything fixed up and cleaned up, and we'll get the track map up here in a second and get everything ready to go. But yeah, Tim Thompson back there out on the track, catching back out to the field, and we should be one to go this time by. We'll take a look at the pace car and see if that is the case, but still 14 cars out there, and now it looks like still two to green here before we get going here, so a little bit longer pace laps here at Iowa, but plenty of racing left to go, and we'll let these guys figure out their shifting points here. And I guess if you get into the session a little later, maybe you don't know how to get them through the gears, but he did for qualifying. Hopefully he knows how to do it on the restart here.
And that's kind of unlike Mark Gonzalez, but he's had issues in the past with some of his restarts. But, you know, once Mark gets going, he's a, you know, one of the faster ones on the track. And as soon as he figures out this line here and how to get this this car around here, you know, I think he's going to be one to be looking at the end of this race, just like last week.
So I think the guys you want to take a look at right now, obviously, you know, up front, James Suggs having some speed. I know Sullivan certainly had some speed, as I seen it in some testing sessions, so it's no surprise to me that he's up there. You got James Ledford and Tyler Bramble up there as well, but keep an eye back there in 11th and 12th. These guys have been kind of the two horses to watch so far for the first two races of the season. That is Sam Oliver in the Taiga Boats paint scheme, and Dylan McDonald back there. Your points there. These two guys should be putting on a good battle, starting side by side, as it was Sam Oliver that got into the back of Tim Thompson and spun him around there. But we're getting ready to go back green now, and it's going to be James Suggs going to be the control car this time by. It'll be in his hands, and we will get this thing back under green, hopefully for more than about an eighth of a lap there.
Yeah, but the pace car is in and we're going green, and James Sugg is on the loud pedal to lead these guys into turn one. No mischiefs this time around, so James will move to the bottom. Looks like Ledford is going to get underneath Sullivan as well and take that P2 away, so Sullivan's going to kind of maintain that high side there just for this first lap until everything settles down.
Yeah, a lot better restart there, and it looked like Suggs, when we got through third and fourth gear, a little bit slower, and it looked like gave Sullivan a chance to get to the outside, but it wasn't to be, and Ledford did indeed move into the second position there, but now it looks like Mark Gonzalez trying to regain his composure here and move his way back up into third. He is right on the bumper of the 76 and diving it all the way down to the bottom. So, you know, for all that talk about the middle line being the preferred line, looks like these guys are all the way down at the bottom, but I'm wondering how much more that is wearing on the tires because, again, progressive banking here at Iowa, which means less banking at the bottom, a little bit more in the middle, and a little bit more at the top. So, you know, you're turning harder at the bottom and should be scrubbing off that tire more, but we'll see how these guys play this thing out as it's not stretching out at all. These guys are all on top of each other yet.
Yeah, these guys are still battling. They don't want to lose each other, as you know, it won't take long being the short track for, you know, people to start lapping each other. And they're getting around here at a pretty decent clip down here at about 25.6. So they're still at qualifying speeds right now. Everybody's pretty much in the orange. The only one kind of falling back a little bit is Craig Pierce, but, you know, he could be on a different strategy. Maybe he's going to try to save the tires a little bit or just take it easy and hopefully just avoid the chaos and, hopefully finish mid-pack as, Pierce is usually out here. Oh, and then Bramble and the Toast Machine gets a little loose up in the James Sullivan, but they collect it together and keep it going.
Yeah, it looks like Bramble got in the corner and went for the pass, but the back end just stepped out on him right away and slid it all the way up the track as we're just about three wide, and no surprise, it's Oliver and McDonald are the ones that are coming through the field with some haste, and looks like Oliver got trapped behind Tilford there. He's going to dive down to the bottom of three wide again.
Wow.
And these guys are getting racy pretty early here. It's on lap 10, but these laps are actually ticking off pretty quickly here. So got to get up through the field as quick as possible. And I know that's what Sam Oliver's trying to do. He's trying to keep on the back of that 38 machine, but he's still stuck three wide and very close. Tilford need to back
nice
out of it. Now they're three wide again. Yeah, exactly. Really good car control back there. But man, again, lap 12, boys, lap 12. Let's just pace ourselves and get this thing under control. But so far, so good. And it is still the 20 of James Suggs out in the lead, out to about a little over half a second right now over James Ledford.
Yeah, he's going to want to keep that clean air as much as possible as, Dylan McDonald and Sam Oliver are going to want to move to the front. And obviously, Sullivan, collecting himself and going to work his way back up to the front with these guys as well. So a lot of speed out here, a lot of different grooves, I guess you want to call them, around here. As you can see, Kevin Foster seemed to be running just a little bit higher line than anybody else. Right, this one here looks like he's falling in behind Mark Gonzalez. So maybe not quite ready, but poking out there to seeing if the little higher lane actually works. But Kevin's currently sitting in that P4.
And really, that is kind of the biggest gap from fourth to fifth right now, as top four still pretty close to each other, and that about a little over three quarters of a second back to fifth place of James Taylor right there. Actually, sorry, Jeff Taylor. So many James in the field, it's bound to happen. But all in all, I mean, these guys are still nose to tail. You see the entire field just, covered in yellow or orange. So there's right on top of each other for battling. And out front, it looks like they're starting to reel in James Suggs a little bit. And this could be a little proc than what he was talking about in his previous interview. Just kind of really trying to manage tires as much as possible. It's definitely going to be at least a one, possibly a two-stop race here tonight. And you want to worry about just running out of fuel, not running out of tire by the end of that stint.
And that's the problem I have with these cars, Carl, when I was driving them quite a few seasons ago. I just could not manage the tires. Get the speed down, done, check. Save tires, no way, didn't happen. Five laps in, I was slow as a turtle and found my way, making my way towards the back. So I just could never get the tire wear down with these cars. Just had a lot of problems with them. So I just found myself being up here in the booth. It's a lot easier to save tire up here.
I'm not running out of gas here in the booth. Well, keep eating some beef jerky, I'll have the exact opposite problem. But up front, looks like we have a change for second place, as you've seen on the screen, as Mark Gonzalez is taking over second place. And now he's trying to run that Hooters machine. Well, Hooters for me and Dewshine for you up towards the front. Either way, it's a good-looking paint scheme. But, yeah, he's He was running down at Suggs there for a minute, and he actually took a dive down into to turn one, but not going to happen just yet as Suggs just pulled away just a little bit more right now. But we have got 14 guys still out there, still on the lead lap. Craig Pierce falling back just a little bit, just kind of running his own race like he normally does. And, yeah, I give it to Craig. You know, he's hardly ever one that's up there, you know, mixing it up in, you know, the middle or even front of the pack. He knows where his pace is. He's out here to try and just, you know, log some laps and get better across the board. And it's what you need to do. I mean, you're not going to get any better by sitting back and watching others race or just, you know, not getting in the race at all. You need to get out there. You need to log laps. And you know, just want to give Craig Pierce a shout out by doing that.
Yeah, he's here week in, week out, and he puts in the time. And I don't know if he showed up to the practice the other night, but, you know, family guy, just out here, loves to race, and has a good time coming out here and giving him a little TV time. And sometimes gets wrapped up in things that probably he doesn't want to be wrapped up in, but I give it to him. He's out here still learning. So, I mean, I put the wheel down with these cars a long time ago, and he's still out here managing to at least keep logging laps. But it looks like Dylan McDonald is going to go ahead and get underneath Kevin Foster, that number 8, and get around him and take that P number 4 away. So move to number 38. But it looks like Kevin's not going to let him go too easily. He's going to try going underneath him and see how the counter move works. As he's able to get underneath him, not past him yet, though, as it looks like that outside is going to be carrying some little more momentum to keep him in that P number 4.
I'm afraid to say that McDonald is running hot right now because he certainly had enough heat issues this week, is having all kinds of heat issues with his CPU and his computer. So, knock on wood, hopefully it's just that car that's running nice and hot right now, not the PC. I know you mentioned about putting a fan on the computer to keep that thing cool until he gets in there and hoses everything down and cools it back off. But doing pretty good up here tonight. You know, obviously started back of the pack since he is the points leader, and now I know that with the rules. But he is up there into fourth place and doing a really good job working his way through the field. And kind of surprised that that Oliver wasn't able to have the same kind of pace going through the field, but he may just be in kind of conservation mode, just like Suggs mentioned before, and he may not be able to as him and Bramble get together. Fantastic save by both drivers right there, and we keep this thing green. That was really, really close to being another caution and some heavily wrecked cars, but a good job saving it from both of those guys.
Yeah, just trying to click on him before I lost him, and they were able to save that. So, good job on those two drivers to maintain control of their car, keep it straight, keep it green. You know, and hopefully no damage was done to those cars, as they look pretty clean still there, Carl.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, these cars are built like tanks a little bit. I mean, when you see them explode off the wall sometimes, like we've seen last week at brain fart now. Like we've seen last week at Nashville Super Speedway, it's they can certainly take damage that way, but you can bump and bang up against each other a little bit, almost kind of like the street stocks, and they'll take it for the most part. But you know, you don't want to do that on the bigger tracks here in Iowa. It's not going to matter that much if you wrinkle up a fender here or there. It's still going to be fine. But right now, not wrinkling anything right now, is James Suggs starting to stretch out his lead. He's out to a second lead now over Mark Gonzalez, as James Ledford now has, I was going to say, a rear view mirror full of Dylan McDonald. Now it's a side view mirror as he is on the outside trying to look for third place.
Yeah, Dylan's on a move. You know, wasn't able to really show his what kind of qualifying time he'd have and if how far of a lead that he might have, or you know, if he would be leading right now. So he's had to make his way from the back of the field, and has done so far, as he has made it up into that P3 position, and now setting his sights on Mark Gonzalez, that's sitting in P2, that is 0.8 seconds behind James Suggs. So I'm sure James is kind of watching the time on Dylan McDonald and showing that he's closing, and hoping that he's saving some tires up there, so if and when Dylan gets up there, he has something for him.
I want to send a shout out and a thank you to everybody out there watching out here tonight. We appreciate all the views as always. And as always, like we say, make sure you hit that like and subscribe to help us out, as we've been slowly, steadily climbing from the beginning of the year already. And you know, looked like we were going to come up short last year of the 300 mark, and then all of a sudden a nice little inflow at the end got us to 300. But since the new year started, we've been starting to rise up here a little bit too. So thank you to everybody that's helping us rise those subscriber numbers and hopefully get us closer to that 500 number that we're looking to try and get to this year. But looks like we already have Craig Pierce is down there on the bottom, just staying out of these guys' way as he is getting lapped right now by the rest of the field. But Mark Gonzalez slowly reeling in James Suggs, and looks like Dylan McDonald also slowly reeling him in. So right now, Dylan McDonald appears to be the fastest man on the track, and looking at the lap times from last lap, that is indeed the case, by a quarter second faster than our leader, James Suggs.
And, you know, Dylan's really pushing them tires, you know, and, you know, I'm sure pits are going to be thought about here shortly. And, you know, who's going to go with two tires? Who's going to go with four tires? You know, as Dylan used up his tires so much that his only option is to go to four tires. So, I mean, we'll see how things pan out here. We're at 33 laps. We're about a third of the way, third of the way done here with the race. And still plenty of action to go. As you can see, Mark Gonzalez looking to that high side to see if he can carry some speed to kind of stay in front of Dylan. It sounded like he scraped the wall there just a little bit.
We're still looking clean for Mark Gonzalez, though. So if it was a scrape, it was barely done. And now he's got to worry about holding on to second place, as he's starting to slip back a little bit from running that high line. He tried it out to see if there's any kind of speed, but clearly there wasn't. So back down to the bottom for the 88, but that middle line now starting to work in as McDonald is all over the backside of Gonzalez. Slowly moving up too is Sam Oliver, now up into fifth place. He's only got, looks like James Ledford in fourth place in between the two of them. So up to top five once again for Sam Oliver. So that puts him up two positions from his starting position to seventh. But Jeff Taylor right behind him is up six positions as well. Started way back there in P12. So a good run through the field by him. And we've got caution. And that involves your championship leader, Dylan McDonald. Comes up off the corner and looks like the 88 just seemed like he was really slow off the corner. Not sure if he was trying to keep it off the wall or not, but McDonald could not keep it off of him. And huge, huge impact for the 88 into the inside wall, and not too much better for the 38. Certainly going to have to check on the safety of that 88. That was pretty vicious into the inside wall, but that will certainly shake things up. The 88 definitely going to need to use a fast repair on that one. The 38 still looks somewhat okay, but I mean, everything that was done, all the good work by the 38 is gone, as it looks like that the hood of that 88 looks like it's about to flip up there. Hopefully it doesn't on him. That would not be an easy way to get back to pit lane with that hood sticking straight up in front of you.
Yeah, 38 also has some damage on his right front. And I'll go ahead and flip around to the back here, as it looks like the rear end kind of came out. So we'll see if these guys decide to take that fast repair now, as we're only one third of the way done with this race, as we are working on lap 37 now, as everybody heads to the pits with the exception of Mr. Tim Thompson. He's going to stay out there, get that lap led, and come back, get a lap led instead of not getting a lap led, or being dumped down into the pits at lap one. So be interesting if he decides to stay out, because I can see the obviously not having enough fuel to make it to the next one. So I'm sure he'll come in here plenty of time, I think, to get that lap led as he comes down pit lane. And the other cars will be coming around as they are now on the back stretch. Yeah, he's just got a little bit farther to go, and he should get this lap led here.
Yeah, and absolutely will do so. So a good move there by Tim Thompson. Yeah, exactly. Getting involved in the start of the race, just getting spun out. But clearly that car looking clean again. I don't think he had to use a fast pair or anything like that. But it is clean once again either way, and able to get the lap lead there. He's going to fall to the back of the field now. Have to work his way back through. I didn't see if we had a lucky dog there for Craig Pierce. It looks like maybe not, so not sure why he didn't get the lucky dog there, but we still have 13 drivers on the lead lap, and we are now on lap 38 of 100.
It didn't take long for 38 laps to go by. I mean, when they go green like this, you know, you kind of wonder, you just look at the lap counter, next thing you know, it's jumped, and these cars really can get around here, and Iowa is a pretty quick track, so.
So I think to bring up, as I notice, our current leader in the King of Core standings is out there watching, and Paul Butler, and I believe, considering who is in the field here tonight, that he will retain that for this week, and he will be the week three leader. But yeah, I mean, a couple new standings here within Core, and that is the King of Core standings and the Clean Driver Award. The Clean Driver Award is pretty simple. It's every driver in Core that is a paid driver, their incidents per lap is what is counted, and for the most part, the guys in this series are at the top of the standings after 2 weeks. I mean, we got a couple guys in this series. Don't want to call out their names or jinx them. You can go on the CRN Facebook page and see who the leaders are, but they have been zero.
All part of us, Carl. Jinx them.
Nope, I'm not gonna do it. Not yet. They have no incidents for the entire year so far. So that's certainly a good way to start the season and capitalize on some good finishes. But the other one, the King of Core, is I don't want to say it's an attempt to find the best driver in Core, but it certainly rewards guys for getting out there and competing every week, and it's almost akin to iRating, where you get points for beating the guys that that maybe you weren't supposed to, and you lose points for losing to the guys that, you know, are lower than you in the standings. So gets you a little bit of an idea of kind of where you sit with the rest of the drivers in Core. But yeah, as of right now, it is Paul Butler on the top of those standings. I can call him out because he ain't out here racing tonight. And taking a look at the rest of it real quick, if I can bring it up here. There we go. One of our drivers is out here tonight, and that is Kevin Foster. He is sitting P2 in the standings. Nick Nickerson, Dakota Camper, and Brett Kuzik right now, the top five in the King of Core standings.
There you go.
But we are ready to go. Pace car is in, and your leader, James Suggs, is back on the lap pedal. Sam Oliver on the pit stops there has moved his way up into second place. So already we see the championship implications, as Dylan McDonald always mentions. His biggest rival so far this year is now in second place, and he's having to work his way back through the field, and already doing so, already passed a couple guys, getting to the outside now of Tim Thompson and easily working around him. So he's got that outside lane working very well, and I don't think it'll be too long until we see him in the top five again.
Yeah, it just seemed
right. Look out in front of him. And behind him, for that matter, David Tilford gets completely sideways, saves it, and then behind him, Tim Thompson does the same thing. A little synchronized spinning there.
Yeah, but I think that was a reaction from. Nice. Yeah, I mean, Dylan went high and around Tilford as he was collecting his car, and Tim Thompson getting heavy on the brakes to collect his car, not getting into Tilford, so there's a lot of sportsmanship there. Slowed him down just a little bit, I'm sure, is. Right tires are a little bit angry at him, but he's going to keep that car going. He gets around Tilford now, as we go, we'll go back to Tim Thompson here real quick, but he's able to get around David Tilford. I was talking to Dave earlier this week in just in Discord, and you know, he's saying how, because he's a road racer, and yeah, he's still trying to find the oval, how these oval cars work and stuff. So you know, he runs a lot of like the way I used to drive, able to find some speed, and then obviously the tires go away, and you know, one bad move and you can lose a lot of positions. But he's doing a pretty good job hanging it out back there. Right now he's currently in that 13th spot as Tim Thompson has gotten around him, and Tim Thompson's chasing down James Carman for P number 11. But back up front, Sam Oliver doing what he did, you know, weeks ago, not too long ago. you know, leading this race. James Suggins in second with Jeff Taylor up 9 positions in that P number 3.
Yeah, a lot of guys, passing is certainly not hard tonight, as we've seen a lot of passing from back to front as Sam Oliver works his way up there, starting in 7th, and now he is finally in the lead. We've seen Dylan McDonald go from the back to the front, trying to do it once again. Mark Gonzalez doing the same thing now, working his way back up into the top 5. Jeff Taylor, though, I mean, can't discount him up a bunch of positions from the start, so a good start by all these guys. And Taylor now trying to work on Suggs and try and get into that second position. So maybe Suggs just trying to, you know, back it off a little bit here on this second run. These guys are still going to most likely need one more pit stop to finish this thing off just on fuel. But you got to make sure, again, you get those tires far enough into this run to you know, kind of make it worthwhile.
Yeah, I mean, you need tires in order to finish out the tank, so... It's really going to be interesting with only one more pit stop remaining, you know, for these guys to end. And, you know, I'm thinking somebody out there is going to try that 2-tire stop. But Dylan McDonald making gathering his composure there just a little bit and working his way back up through the field again. So he's currently up to that 6th spot as he tracks down a Mark Gonzalez that he gotten tangled up with there just a little bit, bringing out that first caution. But he does get around Joseph Sullivan, take that number P6 away, and looking to track down Mark for that P number 5.
Yes, we're just taking a run through the order. You got Sam Oliver leading this thing by just about a half a second, and James Suggs in second, and still doing a pretty good job hanging on the back of that 59 machine. In third place, again, Jeff Taylor up a decent amount of positions here to start this thing, as he is up 9 positions from his 12th place starting spot. Looking at fourth place, you got James Ledford, who started in fourth and is still running fourth, so a good, just nice, even keel run for Ledford so far. Mark Gonzalez started in P3, had the incident with Dylan McDonald that slid him back towards the back of the field, but he's worked his way up into the top 5 once again. And then right behind the man that we just talked about, Dylan McDonald, back up into to P6, so he's certainly got a fast machine out here tonight once again. Joseph Sullivan sliding back a little bit. He had the pace early, but, you know, maybe the race not coming to him just yet, as he's back 5 positions from his second place starting spot there in 7th. Looking back in 8th, you have Tyler Bramble. He certainly had a couple close moments here in the race, but he's got that Santos machine running pretty decent right now in 8th position. Kevin Foster just kind of doing Kevin Foster things, not really being on the eyes of anybody right now, just kind of hanging back there and letting these laps tick by and probably saving tires. And you know as well as I do, saving fuel and trying to see what he can do with the strategy of this thing. But sitting back there in 9th place right now, and then rounding out your top 10, you have the battle right here between Brendan Pult on the outside and James Carman on the inside there, as Pult is going to hold on to it for the time being. And that leaves Carman in 11th place. Then looking back, we have the two synchronized spinners from earlier as they're doing battle. And David Tilford now around the outside. He is going to take back over 12th position. And that will leave Tim Thompson back there in 13th place, as he's just kind of doing, just like Kevin Foster, just doing Tim Thompson things, just kind of riding this thing out, being nice and safe, especially after the early incident. But still got that car intact. And then finally on the lead lap here, he did get his lap back. That is Craig Pierce out here in 14th. So 14 cars still out there, still running. We're past halfway. And Jimmy, I think it's about time to crank these guys up, give everybody out there a chance. I'd love to hear it.
Yeah, we're going to go ahead and crank these guys up, give them a little love to hear it, the sights and sounds of the 87s here at Iowa.
now on lap 65 of 100, Sam Oliver still out to the lead over James Suggs. 1.4 seconds as he's kind of lingering around there. Then Jeff Taylor in third place. James Ledford in fourth. Dylan McDonald sitting in P number five with Mark Gonzalez in number six. Joseph Sullivan in P number seven. Kevin Foster moving up a few spots, find himself in P number eight right at the moment. Then James Carman finds himself in P number nine. Tyler Bramble in the sad toast there in P number 10. David Tilford in 11th. Brandon Polt in P number 12. Tim Thompson had a little bit of issue I could see earlier. Sliding them back right now to P number 13, so I'm sure Tim's out there maybe hoping to catch a caution before he gets put a lap down with Craig Pierce that's in our 14th spot right now. And if I'm not mistaken, let me see if I can go back and see what happened to Tim. If I can. Oh, where'd my mouse go? There it is. I don't think I said anything in particular came up. I know Tim had a little bit of issues. I don't know if he just got a little bit loose and had a checkup or whatnot. But Sam Oliver getting it done right now. 68 laps of 100 here at Iowa.
Yeah, trying to check out and get away before McDonald gets up there. Headed up to 1.5 seconds, and that's the biggest lead we've seen all night tonight. But now starting to shrink a little bit again as Suggs is maybe getting a little help from Ledford, but Ledford is actually back there a full second as well, and he's got his mirror full of McDonald now, as McDonald finally made it around Mark Gonzalez cleanly this time. And yeah, just a little bit of a, you know, worst case scenario as Mark came off the corner a little bit slow, and Dylan was having a good run off the bottom, and pretty much nothing you could do at that point. And when the guy checks up in front of you and you have that good run, it then
Mark Gonzalez tagging
more along. Issues there for Mark Gonzalez, as he's going to lose a couple of positions there, as on the outside Sullivan and Taylor will be able to get around him. But we now have 31 laps to go, and it's a question now of when these guys are going to come into the pits. I don't think they can make it 64 laps on fuel. We'll have to certainly take a look and see if anybody elects to come in early. I mean, it's been a clean race here, so maybe not too worried about a caution coming out and kind of messing with your strategy, but the tires are certainly going to be wanting to come in early. I mean, that right now it looks like the lead is starting to shrink again. James Suggs may be coming alive here at the end of this run as he has it down to a second. And Ledford now a half a second right behind him, and then a half a second back to McDonald. So it's starting to get a little closer here up front.
Yeah, Sam Oliver obviously using up them tires as, you know, the stint's about over. He's going to need gas and pulling it in. Right now, them guys are running 26 nines. You know, they qualified with 25 fives, so a second and a half off the pace. That's a lot of time. I could see somebody doing a short pit and taking this thing to the end.
Fastest guy on the track right now is third place James Ledford for the last couple laps here, as leader that last time by ran a 27.1. James Suggs with a 26.99 and James Ledford with a 26.90. And actually, Joseph Sullivan, that lap, that lap was a 26.8. So a lot of speed here in the top five, and it's not necessarily by the leader. So these guys are all starting to kind of reel each other in and could have a good mix up here before the end of this stint, let alone the end of the race.
Yeah, and James Ledford just got around James Sugg for that P number two. So he's going to see if he can chase down Sam Oliver. And we talked to our in-car reporter and the number 20 of James Suggs earlier. And when we pulled him up in the room, he asked if Ledford was still here. So I guess wherever you were talking to him, they were talking to each other as we interrupted their conversation. But Ledford is now in P number two, catching up to Sam Oliver. Does he have enough to catch him? Who's going to pit? When they going to pit? 25 laps or 26 laps remaining here at Iowa.
Give a shout out to one of the drivers out here in the series, not here tonight, as I believe he's in Nashville, Tennessee right now on work, and that is B. Vishavasham, but see him out there. They're watching, and mentioned that Tim Thompson has twice as many, five times as many, whatever you want to call it, laps led than a B is, as he did lead a lap here tonight, and that's more than a B's led all season. So once he gets back, we'll see if he can do what he typically does and stays out there in an early caution, gets his lap led, and and see if he can compete. But we got a little competition here as McDonald was able to get around James Suggs to move up into third place. And now the lead is starting to stretch out again. So maybe Sam Oller playing a little cat and mouse. He stretched that thing back out to a 1 second lead. And McDonald has to get those tires cooled down a little bit as he struggled to get around Suggs for a little bit there. And he has to kind of wrangle that car back in. And it's funny on my end because we're in a Wrangler scheme, but it's certainly not on your end. No. But he is... he's on the move once again, and both your top two in points are in the top three in the race here. Hunter Taylor is third place in the points, not in attendance here tonight. So that brings you back to fourth place in points, James Ledford, and you see him obviously in third there. And then James Carman in fifth place in points. So a good start to the season for Carman, but pit stops are starting, and the first one taking it in here is Jeff Taylor. He's going to bring that 24 machine in here. So the first one into pit road is the 24. We'll see if that starts a chain of events and see more guys coming in the pits, or if this is just a nice early short pit to try and get that 24 up forward towards the front more.
I mean, yeah, he's got to try something to kind of mix it up just a little bit as he brings that number 24 down to pit lane. See Tim Thompson taking the pit lane right now as well as... You know, these guys are going to go a lap down, but it looks like Jeff taking a gamble here. He's going to come on out and try to see if he can make up any positions here. Make sure he's not going too fast coming out. And making sure he's leaving Honey open to pit and not a closed pit, or he'll have to come right back in. But Sam Oliver out front. We should be seeing these guys come in soon. The man that they're kind of keeping an eye on now, though, is Jeff Taylor as he was running towards the front. We'll see if his strategy pays out for him at the end as Mark Gonzalez is now down into the pits as he was having a little bit of trouble and found himself sliding backwards just a little bit. So he's going to come in here and get some much needed probably right side tires at a minimum and the fuel that's needed to finish up this race.
Well, it's funny you say right side tires, Jimmy, because that is all Jeff Taylor took. He only took right side tires, so... We'll see if that is going to pay dividends. We'll see if it is the right gamble here. See if anybody else goes with that. It looks like the 88 going to go with that strategy as well, taking two tires, and he is done, fired off, and back out, joining the race here. Those are the only three that have come down pit lane so far, being the 24, the 88, and the 05, and it looks like the 24 of Taylor going to get around Mark Gonzalez right there. So both these guys, maybe now they can hook up together and try and run some good laps and get back up towards the front, as Gonzalez is gonna have to slide in between. And so speaking of sliding all the way up through turn one, and he is gonna bring out another caution, and that is not good for the 88, as he is one lap down. He'll be able to get the wave around if he doesn't have too much damage, but that will give everybody a free pit stop. And it looks like Brendan Pult was already in pit, so I'm not sure how that's going to work out with the lucky dog. If it's going to go to Jeff Taylor, if not, obviously he'll take the wave around and come back out there. But a short pit certainly not working out for Taylor or for Gonzalez. And Tim Thompson stuck back there two laps down. He's only going to be able to get one lap back if he stays out. So this caution couldn't have come at a worse time for those drivers, and at a better time for your leader here, Sam Oliver, and the rest of the field, as they will all bring it in right here.
Yeah, and that was the gamble that they made, and Jeff Taylor is going to stay out. He's got right side tires on. Just took if he got the lucky dog, he'll be able to come around and obviously take four tires, because it looks like Dave Tilford missed the pit road.
Yeah, or maybe testing out the little faux drag strip right there as he's flying down the infield.
I mean, so does it give you an off track? Can you actually go around down there? Is it faster?
That's a good question. All good questions. But it looks like Taylor was awarded the lucky dog, so that is big, big help there for Taylor, because, I mean, with this being the case here, you got 15 laps to go the next time by here. Right now it's 16. I mean, I don't know if you're taking two tires. I mean, it looks like so far most of our leaders are doing that, but now if I'm Jeff Taylor right here, I'm coming back in. I'm getting all four tires. I'm already going to start the back of the pit or the back of the line anyway. Unless I really need two tires just to get this thing to rotate through the corner, I'm taking four tires. I'm going to try and work my way through the field, and it looks like that's exactly what Dylan McDonald and a lot of the rest of the guys do. So it's only Sam Oliver and Tyler Bramble out there with two tires. And then you got Dylan McDonald going to have four. Jeff Suggs going to have four. Sullivan, Ledford, all the rest of the field pretty much are going to have four freshies to try and go after both Oliver and Bramble.
Yeah, and, you know, unfortunately, Carl, I don't have the practice on here to be able to tell you whether how much the difference is between, you know, two rights and four fresh tires. The one thing I do know is just having rights, you are going to loosen up that car. And by the look of it, it didn't pay out for Gonzalez, as he, you know, he got loose and ended up spinning that car around and had to bring it back down. So sliding back all the way to currently, it looks like he's in 11th position on the lead lap.
Yeah, he is at the front of this pack here, so I'll end up getting the wave around. So he is going to rejoin. He's going to probably need another caution, though, because he is on two tires as well, and he's got a bunch of guys in front of him on four tires. So, you know, unless those two tires just really work that much better than four, I'd rather have that comfortability of having four at this point, especially if I'm, you know, one of the guys behind Sam Oliver. I mean, Sam Oliver obviously had the speed on the four tire run there. So now if you can try and you know, switch up strategies, he's got two. Tyler Bramble now in second place. He got that sad toast all the way up there in second. So certainly, you know, to the liking, I'm sure, of his fans out there watching. But, you know, I'm happy to be on four right now. That's certainly where I'd want to be and try and run this thing to the end. And that'll probably be the last time you see anybody come down pit road. Unless you're towards the back, if we get another caution here, but we're going to be getting this thing back going with about 11 or 12 laps to go. So it is go time here in Iowa, and we'll see if strategy is going to pay off.
Yeah, strategy is, you know, a thing. And, you know, choices in pit lane, you know, they do matter still, you know, with, you know, under caution, but not as much, especially under green. And the guys taking a little early gamble to come in, not thinking, as they were doing a great job keeping this thing green, catching a caution here late. We are now lap 88. We have Sam Oliver up front, Tyler Bramble in second, James Suggs in third, Dylan McDonald's in fourth, Joseph Sullivan's in fifth, James Ledford in sixth, Kevin Foster in seventh, James Carman in eighth, David Tilford in ninth, Jeff Taylor in 10th. 11th is Mark Gonzalez, and then 12th is Craig Pierce, Brandon Pohl in 13th, and Tim Thompson in 14th.
We've got 13 to go, 12 at the line here. Who do you got? Who do you think's going to bring this thing home? What do you think the strategy call was? Who do you think had it right? It's about ready to get shaken out here, as we may see a repeat winner. We may see a new winner. The existing winners of Oliver and McDonald are both up there at the front, and this thing is back green and racing. And actually, it's not McDonald. It was Mark Gonzalez that had the win last week at Nashville. But Suggs already all over the side of the 59, not able to get completely alongside and make those four tires work just yet. But both of them, including the 76 of Joseph Sullivan, already getting by Tyler Bramble. So the two tires not working out for him on the restart here, as they've got a hornet's nest chasing that 59 of Oliver.
Yeah, and then back up here up front, James Suggs has his hands full with Dylan McDonald as he goes to the low side. Oh, Joseph Sullivan tags it back in to James Suggs as he goes spinning down the front or back stretch. That will bring out another caution, so that's going to help out the guys on the back and the guys who need them tires to get them four freshies.
Yeah, certainly going to help out. You know, for instance, Mark Gonzalez is able to come back in now, and we'll take a look at what happened. It looks like pretty much the same situation as the 20 getting a little bit slow coming out of the corner. He wasn't close to the wall, so I'm not sure why he was getting that slow. And Sullivan just really nowhere to go on that one. It's going to send the 20 spinning, but looks like no harm, no foul. I don't think he touched anything on the way in here, as he's maybe not, as he starts sliding down towards the infield here. But it does look like he gets it wowed up just in time, just in the nick of time, leaving some nice little tire marks there on the backside of Iowa, but
you're warmed up now.
Yeah, really no damage, and I'm sure he'll bring that thing back down and get some four freshies to get this thing back going, but now buried in the pack. So our pole sitter here tonight, our in-race reporter, has got a lot of work to do here to finish this thing out, as we are now 9 laps to go, and by the time we get this thing back going, it's going to be close to 5.
Yeah, it's going to be a big old shootout, and you know the way these guys race and how competitive they are, I would not be surprised to see if there's one more caution. But hopefully these guys can keep clean, keep it off each other, finish this thing out under green, as it is going to be a few lap shootout. But Sam Oliver leading the way over Dylan McDonald, Joseph Sullivan, Tyler Bramble, Kevin Foster for your top 5, then James Ledford, James Carman, David Tilford, James Suggs, and Mark Gonzalez for your top 10, then Jeff Taylor, Brendan Polt, Tim Thompson, and Craig Pierce for a 14 car field here tonight at Iowa.
I will tell you that one of the guys that I did not want to jinx that was without an incident this year was the 20 of James Suggs. That's not going to be the case anymore, so he will take his first hits here tonight. The other one, I'm not sure if he was involved in an incident. I don't think so, but again, I'm not going to jinx him, as it's still a chance for him to possibly finish here with 0x. But yeah, these laps are now just ticking away, and this is everything that Sam Oliver wants to see. But I mean, no shocker so far through the first two races, it's been these two guys up front, with Mark Gonzalez sneaking that win last week. And, kind of thought he would have a chance here tonight, but just a lot of issues with, obviously getting into the incident with Dylan McDonald, and then kind of getting caught right there at the wrong spot and not getting the tires heated up, and then brings out another caution. So just one of those kind of up and down Mark Gonzalez nights, but he is on the lead lap. He's got fresh tires, and we'll see what he can do and try and run up through this field and at least salvage some points here for the end.
Yeah, he's got to do what he can to get up to the front. And, only being 7 rows back, I mean, he does have that chance, that the ability to get up there and sneak in the top 10, maybe get around some of the slower guys that have been a little bit slower here tonight than him. But
I'm sure what happened with Dylan McDonald there is he just gets into the wall on the front stretch.
Maybe he's eating pizza.
Well, hopefully it's that, and hopefully it's not dripping on that hot computer. that was just kind of random. He just gets in the outside wall there.
Somebody has stopped. Joseph Sullivan.
Yeah, not sure what's going on with these guys here.
Yeah,
it might have been Sullivan getting the EOL here.
Okay, yeah, it would make a lot of sense.
Yeah, it might be Sullivan getting the EOL, and that's a shame for the 76. So he had a really good running spot, but I know Barry is out there watching, and he's already made the comment on it, but take a look where that number 8 is. He is slowly and secretly moved himself up into the top 5, and now with the EOL
quiet
to Sullivan, he's up
on
to P4. So we'll see what the 8 has in store for us to finish this thing out. He's going to be starting second on the outside row behind Dylan McDonald, so certainly hoping that McDonald gets a good restart. Both these guys would like to race this thing out, but they've got to get around. Well, Kevin's got to get around Tyler Bramble on the inside there in third, but both of these guys, all three of them, somebody's got to get around Sam Oliver if they want this win.
Yeah, and I think that's going to be a tough feat here. I know Dylan's aggressive, and he has the ability to do so. He's going to have to be a little patient, make sure that he can get a nice clean pass and not spin him around, causing him to gain any more incident points or a penalty. So, but he does have he has the speed, and I think that Dylan has an opportunity to get around Sam, but basically maintain his points lead in the championship here. But we're getting ready to go green here as the pace car is coming down around turn 4, and you should see him dive down to the inside here. And he does, and Sam Oliver will bring him here to the green.
And already on the lap pedal is Sam Oliver, getting a really good restart here. And these guys better make quick work of each other. 5 laps to go here at Iowa, and Kevin Foster all over the backside of that 38. It's actually going to help Dylan as he gets a fantastic run coming out of 2, down to the inside, battle for the lead. McDonald going to dive it down and make those four tires work as he is going to try and get around Sam Oliver. Not going to happen just yet. I thought I heard some screeching back there, but it looks like everybody's still clean. McDonald going to clear the 59, but now here comes Kevin Foster to the inside. He's going to get around the 59 and battle McDonald, but here comes a crossover move from Oliver. It is go time here in Iowa, Jimmy. We got four to go down the backstretch. It is McDonald, Oliver, and Foster. Oliver trying to make those two tires work and trying to make that strategy work as they're all over each other behind them as well.
And Jeff Taylor is just on a move. He's on a mission. He made it go three wide between James Carman and Tyler Bramble, making it work. Those guys keeping it off each other. What a battle back here for that fourth position as Jeff Taylor is making his way back up to the front, trying to catch these guys as we only have three laps to go. Tyler Bramble taking a dive underneath Jeff Taylor, trying to make it stick, but not able to as Jeff Taylor will maintain that P number four. It's Mark Gonzalez now up to P number five. Dylan McDonald is in the lead over Sam Oliver by 0.194. Sam Oliver trying to fight back as Kevin Foster seemed to lost a little bit of pep there, but probably happy with the P number three as he's been quiet all night. Tyler Bramble and Mark Gonzalez switching places between fifth and sixth. And then back there in seventh, you have James Carman up four spots, fighting with James Suggs. James Suggs doing the best he can to finish off this race here as we come down to the last white flag.
Flag in the air, and the top three is McDonald, Oliver, and Foster, and it's not over just yet. Oliver right back to the back bumper of the 38. Not going to be close enough, though. They're going to head down into turn three. One last shot for Oliver. He gets down to the inside, gets alongside of the 38. Drag race off of turn four. Just about getting in the back of the 38, but it's going to be McDonald holding on for the win. He takes the points lead. Penalty to go from the back of the field, and he gets it done back to the front, and looks like Mark Gonzalez edging out Jeff Taylor there for fourth place. So a great comeback for the 88 there. Jeff Taylor also a good comeback, finishing in fifth. Man, 100 laps down here at Iowa. I want 100 more.
I mean, right down there to the end. You know, I didn't know if I could run out. I thought I was going to run out of air trying to go down to the list of people there prior to the last lap and still give you a little time to call the end. But Dylan McDonald doing a great job finishing this up, winning here tonight at Iowa. 100 laps done. A few cautions, a few whoopsies, getting wrangled up in a few incidents, but Sam Oliver having a nice solid finish there in P number two, along with Kevin Foster in number three. Mark Gonzalez fighting his way back to finish in fourth place. Jeff Taylor, though, you know, doing an awesome job of finishing in P number five, up seven spots tonight. He, you know, right tied with Kevin Foster as far as the biggest mover. I know Dylan McDonald is technically the biggest mover, but, you know, points guy, blah, blah, blah. But anyways, he'll get us popped in the booth here when we get to talk to him. But James Suggs, after getting tied up in that incident and starting on the pole, still coming away with a top set, you know, top 10, finishing that set P number seven, still doing a great job. So great run there for James Suggs at the end, making up what he could. James Carman finding himself up three spots and finishing number eighth. And then you had James Ledford, Joseph Sullivan, David Tilford, Brandon Polt, Tim Thompson, and Craig Pierce rounding out our field here tonight.
So we will go ahead and start bringing in our top three here, and we're going to start off with Kevin Foster. And Kevin, I guess, you know, no surprise to us, and I'm sure no surprise to a lot of your fans out there, especially Barry out there. Yeah, we all kind of wait and don't really talk about you until the end of the race, because that's when the number eight comes alive. And it looks like you just kind of bided your time here tonight, and you had one heck of a battle there at the end. Did you have a little peek there at the lead and think you had a chance?
I had a peek. I mean, I was, you know, coming down, went three, took a three wide there, and I was like, man, this is going to be great. Hopefully these guys mix it up. And I just, you know, overdrove it. It's this car, you know, you guys know this track, you cannot overdrive this car.
No, you overdrive it, and you're waiting for another three, four laps to cool those tires down. And I'm guessing that's what kind of slid you back there at the end. But, I mean, a heck of a comeback here. And it seemed like you guys taking the four tires were able to work your way through the field. A couple guys taking two tires there at the end as Dale McDonald celebrating India there a little bit. But, yeah. I mean, tell us what the race was like. I mean, you're hanging out in the back for most of the race, and then at the end that thing came alive.
Yeah. Well, if the caution wouldn't come out, I was good to go. I was when the caution came out, though, I was six laps to the good there, so I did not want to see that caution come out. I was good. So besides that, just you know, and the sad thing is, and the funny thing is, that when I was saving fuel, I was running almost equal lap times as I was, you know, pushing it. So definitely saving fuel was the right strategy for me. Unfortunately, Mark got a little loose there and didn't work out for that. But yeah, just hung out in the back by the time. I know it's a long race, and a lot of things can happen in a long race. And fortunately, had that caution there and able to come get four tires and restart seventh and, you know, drive my way to third.
Well, Barry's certainly out there proud of you, and I'm sure you're happy with the top three either way. But we'll give you a little chance here to give some shout outs and thanks before we let you go.
All right. First off, Barry, one day, brother, one day soon, it's gonna come, you know, and you know, it's gonna be for you, Barry. But you know, big thanks to the Core Racing League, CRN, for broadcasting. You know, great platform for us to come out here, have some fun, you guys to broadcast it for us, and our fans to enjoy it. You know, great. Hats off to Dylan and Sam for 1-2. You know, I was trying to get my first win in a Buick. I got wins in both other manufacturers, so I don't know if I'd be the first one with a win in all three manufacturers. But you know, it's coming, and so next week I think we got a week off, right?
Let me see here.
I don't know.
I'm off guard there. And looks like no. We are back. Well, maybe a week off if you don't want to run the road course as the one and only road course next week at Watkins Glen. So yeah, you get to turn right for once.
Yeah, and the fun thing is the 87 car at Watkins Glen is it's actually really, really fun, and hoping for a top five there. You know, that's what I can expect. And then we go dirt track racing in Knoxville, right?
Yep, later in the season. No, it's actually Bristol Dirt is later in the season, the 10th race of the season. So it sounds like you're already looking forward to that. But yeah, I mean, looking at the rest of the schedule, what are some of the races that you're looking forward to try and get that win for Barry out there?
Anything that does not involve turning right. These cars, you turn right enough at these tracks, just because they're, you know, a handful. But it's one of the, you know, most challenging cars in the sim. But Pocono.
And unfortunately, yeah, Pocono not on the schedule this year. So, I mean, but a big sister to Pocono is probably Indianapolis, and that is that's coming up after Watkins Glen. So, Indianapolis certainly has a little bit of Pocono in it, with the you know, turn two at Pocono being kind of modeled after the Indianapolis track. So,
could see the could see the eight there. Indy's always a fun track. It's, you know, it's wide open and not much strategy there, though. It's just, you know, generally it's the fastest car because, you know, things get so spread out there and you don't have a chance to really, from my standpoint, save fuel. But, you know what I mean? Hats off to Dylan, and hopefully this is for the King of Core. Hopefully this, you know, didn't hurt me too bad finishing third tonight. But, you know, overall, look for the rest of the season. We got, what, seven races left after this, and gotta go with that championship. That's what I'm after.
Yeah, the championship is still certainly in the running, and this may get you close to Butler for the top spot in the King of Core. But either way, you should be sitting pretty. But good run here tonight, good third place, and we'll certainly see you next week.
And one more question: do we have a drop race in this league or no?
In this league, there are two drop races.
Thanks. So perfect. Yep,
you got a couple options there to have a stinker. So
I did miss the first one. So
already looking forward to Watkins Glen the way it sounds, talking about drop races. So
No. I'm up for the challenge. Like I said, I love the track, and maybe Carl, maybe you can give me some pointers on how to drive that thing fast.
We can certainly talk money after the race here and work something out.
All right, guys. I appreciate you guys. Thank you.
Good run tonight, Kev.
Thank you.
That's your third place finisher, the eight of Kevin Foster. And now, Jimmy, why don't you go ahead and take our second place finisher, Sam Oliver.
Hey, Sam, Jimmy, and Carl up in the booth. You copy?
Gotcha.
Hey, another week up here in the booth, finishing out second, being edged out over by Dylan McDonald this week here at Iowa. It looked like you had a pretty decent car and you let a lot of laps. Did you have something for Dylan at the end there, or did your pitch strategy of two tires just not pay out for you here tonight?
Well, it definitely didn't pay out. You know, I think if it had been anybody else besides Dylan behind me, I probably could have held on for the win. I thought more people would take two on that last pit stop and try and sneak some track position. But all in all, pretty solid day. Had some early adversity and really struggled the first quarter of the race trying to get through some traffic. Caught some damage to the car and ended up just slowly making my way up there.
Yeah, I mean, if that's one thing that you took from tonight was you know, overcoming the adversity, leading the race, putting yourself out front, and you know, finishing second and getting a good points night and for the week here, keep you in that contention for that you know, that all and behold a core championship. So again, just wanted to give you, you know, the congratulations that you deserve and give you a little bit of time for any shout outs you might have.
Thanks, guys. It was a fun race. Really enjoyed it. Congrats to Dylan on the win. He probably had the better car tonight, but look forward to racing more this season with him and the rest of the guys. And thanks for the broadcast, and see y'all next Thursday.
We'll definitely see you next Thursday as we head to our one and only road course. So how you feel about going right along with lefts?
I just try and keep it on track at those places and let the finish happens where it does. You know, it's tough to drive these cars on those tracks.
Yeah, definitely a little bit challenging, but we'll look forward to seeing you there and hopefully see you up here in the booth again next week.
That your second place finisher, the 59 of Sam Oliver. Now we bring in Dylan McDonald, and Dylan, it's starting to make sense here. I mean, all you need is a computer that runs too hot. You need to get zero sleep. And I don't think you lied to me at all this week to get the win, but man, four tires at the end, a little bit of a mix up there with Mark Gonzalez in the middle of the race, but you drove that thing from back to the front twice and showed that you're the points leader for a reason.
Yeah, for what, I'm super tired. I got a little bit of sleep, slept until about 8 o'clock. And then I read that we had updates, so I had to hurry up, get on there and do the update. But I really wish I had a 0X. Got in the back of Mark Gonzalez. He was checking up to not hit the wall, and I just had nowhere else to go. So apologize to him for that. But yeah, it's all about patience, and I've been using that to my advantage here as of late. And, you know, finishing second the first two races and getting my first win here tonight, you know, just shows that I'm here to have a better season than the last two seasons, especially last season at Rockingham, you know, learning how to not win a race with Dylan McDonald, you know, spinning myself out and having all that. So that was a little bit of a redemption for me. But it felt like I had Kevin Foster all over my rear bumper there and coming out of four. And I had a look and see who it was. It was Sam. And I was like, okay, this is going to end one of two ways. He's going to dive it in, slide up, hit me, and we're both not going to win, and Kevin's going to get the win, or he's going to play it smart and have a good fight to the finish. And that's exactly what happened. And just finally, I got the camel off my back. I can relax a little bit. Finally got another win and move on to next week.
You got the Chris Hamlin off your back too after finishing bridesmaid the first two races here and finally crack through for the win. So I mean, we there's a lot of tracks that we go to that is just all about track position, and you really need to nail down your pitch strategies to move you up through the field, because passing is at a premium. That wasn't really the case here tonight, though. I mean, you were able to bring that car from the back to the front multiple times, and we've seen other guys doing the same thing. So I mean, what was it that just made it easier to pass here tonight? Was it just multiple lines? Was it that you just had, you know, superior handling on the car? You know, what was it in your mindset?
Coming into practice, like all week, I put in 500-600 laps just for this race, just throw up an AI session and just go. Want to see how the top works, want to see how the bottom works. And you just kind of pick and choose where you want to go. With it being a multiple lane track, I knew the top was going to be a little bit more dominant than the bottom. You're going to burn a way more tire on the bottom as well. So I just wanted to keep it away from the bottom. You're going to battle tightness down there. In practice, that's all I did. run a couple laps on the bottom, run a couple laps on top, find out what I liked personally, and the top was the way to go, and just got to play with the throttle just a little bit coming off the corner, because if you got back on the throttle a little bit too quickly, it was a little bit snappy in the rear end, and the way that the car turned all the way through the corner, you know, backing it down off the throttle and making the front end turn really helped me get through the corners. And it was definitely a struggle. Just, I had the moment in my head, like, come on, let's just push it to the front. Let's just push a little bit more. But then I had like little Jimmy in my head, whispering sweet nothings, patience, and like I said, it all worked out, and that was exhausting, very exhausting. If that caution didn't come out, I was going to go in, take two tires, come back out, and luckily the caution came out, and I didn't have to worry about getting into pit road under green flag conditions.
Yeah, I mean, I think you hit one of the main things that makes you as good as you are, especially this year, is you were absolutely putting in the time. I mean, every time I talk to you, you're talking about practicing, and you're putting in a ton of laps to practice every week. And, you know, this is, you know, not for nothing coming from a championship driver. You won this championship 3 seasons ago, had a couple seasons in a row that you know, we're not up to your standards, and anything and everything was going wrong for you, but you've certainly righted the ship. You put in the time this year, and it's paying off with a second and a first, and now you get to start from the back of the pack next week at Watkins Glen. So thoughts?
That's a bad thing, honestly. I think I may just start from the pits, let everybody get through turn one, and just see where it comes. But Watkins Glen is going to be, oh, we ran this race, what, last season? It did not handle the same way that we ran it when the video came out for the intro. And yeah, it's going to be a lot of practice again. I mean, every single week I'm going to do self-practice and, you know, hang out with Tim and James Carman and whoever else needs practice at every other track. I mean, I have a lot of tracks coming up that I personally love, especially Indianapolis and then Rockingham. So it's definitely going to be fun for me. And hopefully I can just keep the points lead and work my way through the pack, because there's nothing better than having to start from the back and showing your patience and doing it the right way instead of being a
bull in a china closet.
Yeah, you know, being that guy and be like, all right, you know what? I know I can make it through the front. Let's just run through everybody. I don't want to be that way. And I kind of lost myself there a couple of seasons ago, and that's all I was doing. I just wanted to hurry up and get to the front. And this season, I want to take the time to relax, find myself, get up to the front, and just show the people all the respect that they deserve.
He's learning. He's evolving, Jimmy. He's picking stuff up.
I'm rubbed off on him.
but all in all, I mean, just hats off to you. A great run here tonight, and you certainly had a fast car. Whether the cautions fell your way or not, you were going to find your way to the front. But first win on the season now. We'll see. I'm sure that 38 run up towards the front some more, maybe even next week already. But before we let you go ahead and give you your chance to give some shout outs and thanks.
All right. First off, got to give a big shout out to you guys up there in the booth week in and week out, making this all possible. Got to thank everybody for the vantage that comes out, you know, 14, 15 guys, even more, depending on how many entries we get. Thank you for letting this season come back. It's always been a great season. Got to thank Ray's Energy, Joker Graphics for the beautiful car, Wes Fuller over at Title Town Racing, WW Motorsports, Travis Auto Services, and Towing, Upstate Body Shop and Towing, 213 Simware, just everybody in Core as a whole, Premier, GT, everything. It's always been a blast watching everybody come in and out of here and make them a better racer throughout the week.
Yeah, it's certainly fun. It's been a blast running with you. I wish I could be out there, but I'm sure you're happy I'm not.
Yeah. I am glad you're back up in the booth.
but listen, take some time, enjoy this, and then go ahead and get some sleep. I know you're exhausted, and you have a nice little time off here until the Premier Series race on Sunday. So congrats again on the win, and we'll see you soon.
Oh, yeah, I already took a 12-hour nap, so we're good.
You sound like you need another 12-hour nap, so go ahead and relax a little bit.
Yeah, I'm starting to lose my voice, so this is going to be fun come Sunday.
All right, buddy. We'll let you go.
All right. Thanks, man.
All right, that your winner here tonight, the 38 of Dylan McDonald, and looking like the Dylan McDonald of old, and really out here and doing a lot of good driving out here. And you heard it that he's a little bit smarter now, and you know, even changed from his championship run. I mean, his championship run, he was still that old Dylan McDonald that would try and you know, kind of bully his way up through the field, but not the case tonight, not the case this season. He's maybe matured a little bit, but it's not going to be easy. He's got guys nipping at his heels. Obviously, Sam Oliver is his biggest threat right now in the standings and in every race for that matter. And Kevin Foster coming into form here a little bit tonight, finishing in third. And can't count out James Ledford. James Suggs was up there. Even had Tyler Bramble, you know, sneaking up there into the top three for a little bit towards the end. So there's a lot of meat here. Like we said last week, a lot of meat on the bone here for the Vintage Cup Series title. So he's not going to have it just that easy. But that is it here for Iowa. Again, next week we head to Watkins Glen. We head to the Finger Lakes region for the one and only road course for these guys, as they'll get a chance to turn right. On purpose, as I like to say, and instead of turning right just to save the car. But it should be an interesting one to see there. But before that, we have all the rest of the action here on CRN, and that's going to start on Sunday night as the Premier Series is going to head to Knoxville with the Dirt Street Stock. So get to see some dirt track action there, some heat racing, some alphabet soup. We're going to be a good one there with a 50-lap feature. The GT Series is going to be on Monday night at the Watkins Glen Classic Boot. So it'll be Watkins Glen week next week, as it seemed like we had Dover week this past week. But they're going to be at the Watkins Glen extended road course. They're using the boot. Then the ARCA and Truck Series are going to be at IRP. So the short little track there in Indianapolis, as that is usually one that's a little bit tough to pass, and maybe take some slide jobs and crossovers to make that happen before we head back again here for Watkins Glen. But that is it for the Vintage Series and for CRN here tonight at Iowa Speedway. We'll see you at the track.
Peace.
We'll be right back.